Okay, so I had to stop it and restart it just for the simple fact that it's a freaking behemoth. I don't really have time to be planning things out. I just need to fight as fast as possible, be as efficient as possible, hopefully, and I just need to do as much damage as possible in the shortest amount of time as possible, so okay, that didn't hit us for some reason, but I will definitely take it. This behemoth's almost dead just for the sheer fact that we have ranged weapons. He thankfully does not. He actually, the only ranged weapon he has is basically just throwing big ass rocks at us. So, and also we have her as a freaking shield. I mean, I guess Ada is technically a her. Dude, she is getting just completely wrecked. And she's not even fighting or anything, man. She's just like, she's just sitting there taking all the damage. Oh, okay, that one hit me in the face. That's alright. There you go. Did not honestly expect to run into a freaking behemoth here. I mean, just look at this, man. We got a lot of stuff, though, so I'm definitely thankful that we ran into him. Yep, I'm taking that. Taking that as well. And it's time to pop a... Let's see. Strength plus one. That's only plus one. Damn it. Okay, can I make Ada carry some stuff for me? Also, I should level up. What am I doing? I can literally just level up right now. Kind of feel like increasing the strength perk just... Yeah. Just so that I can actually carry more stuff now. I think it's only like 10 points or something that increase my ability. Yeah, so I can actually... I'm still going to try to see if I can get Ada to... Where is she going? Seriously, where is Ada going? Yo, Ada. Get over here,
hey,
woman.
Over here.
I'd be happy to help if I can.
Okay, move just stop here. Right there.
Certainly. Glad to be of service.
Okay, cool. We can actually trade with her, so you can carry that. You can carry that. You can carry this. That's good enough for now. Anyways, welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4. In this episode, we're going to continue where we left off in the last episode, and that is literally by shooting the crap out of, is the more appropriate term to use. Shooting the crap out of a Super Mutant Behemoth. Legendary. What do you have? Wandering Missile Launcher. Target to bleed for 25 points of additional damage. I want to steal that from you so bad. But the second I do, these guys are going to start shooting at me. I'm not going to live long, so it's not a good idea. Anyways, we could just fast travel to everywhere that we need to go in order to make sure that... So let's go to here. We're going to report to Paladin Dance, I believe his name is. Or Dance. Dance, I think his name is. Dance. Whatever his name is. We're basically going to report to him. Oh, there's the robot workbench. Allows for the construction of a wide range of robotics, including combinations never approved by General Atomics International or Robco. The wasteland is home to a variety of dogs, from vicious wild curs to trained attack hounds. Basically, that thing told us that we can make any combination of robot that we want. We don't have to make like a Protectron or an Assaultron. We can make an Assaultron body with the head of a Protectron if we wanted to. It'd probably look ridiculous as hell, but we can do that. Anyways, let's actually go talk to Dance. I know it's under your protection. I think that was a knight. So, soldier is the best word to use. I know it's under your protection, soldier, but we don't really care for it. I don't mean it in the harsh way. I just mean it like, we don't really care that it's under your protection. There's no danger here at all. This is the command center. So, before people even get to the Pridwin, they would have to go through everyone at the airport to get to the vertibirds in order to fly up here, and by the time they fly up here, we'll just destroy the freaking vertibird that they're on. So there's literally no problem at all for us there.
What did you want?
Anyways, let's actually talk to Dance. Dude, why are you so mean?
Excuse me, Paladin Dance?
Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
Not now.
Not now.
No problem.
Mm-hmm.
Can I not?
Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
Okay, ready. Whatever, I'm ready. She's going to Red Rocket Truck Stop, okay.
Hey.
You.
Nope, I didn't mean to do that.
Hey.
What do you want?
Okay, talk.
How do you think...
I think we have the potential.
Okay, no, this is not
team. If you learn to cooperate.
Oh, please don't tell me that.
Your thoughts?
Remember, we're out here.
That's all for now.
Not a problem.
Dude, I'm not able to turn this in anymore. Okay, you know what? Screw this.
Ada?
Would you like me to go with you?
Yes.
Time to hit the road.
Understood.
You can just stay on the Pridwin. I can't believe I can't turn that mission in because I already gotten this far. Dude. Not freaking cool.
The Commonwealth's a dangerous place.
That's annoying. But on the bright side, we technically finished the mission anyways. We're not gonna get the insane amount of XP that we normally would get for finishing that mission, but I mean, I can't really complain much. Managed to do the mission. We managed to convince the other paladin to join again. So everything's not that bad. Also, my dog is like licking his butt really heavily. So I guess we'll just fast travel back to the police station to talk to the scribe, and then we'll give her the stuff. Flux capacitor, I think it was, that she was asking for. We'll just give her the flux capacitor, collect our reward, get another mission. Then I think we'll be ready to continue with more missions or something. I honestly don't know. I kind of, I wanted to be able to get about 500 XP for both missions, because they were basically in the same location, so I could have done both, which I did. I basically managed to do both at the same time. I found the recon team, I also recovered the flux capacitor in the same video, essentially, but that didn't really end up working out the same way, the way that I wanted it, or I anticipated it to work out, but I guess we can't really do much about that. Much ado about nothing. Also, my dog is just looking at me. He's scratching himself. Dude, it's so weird having how animals like scratch themselves. I just feel bad. Like, for us, we have, you know, opposable thumbs. We can move our arms because we're bipedal. So, like, we basically can stand on 2 feet.
Good.
So we have our two other limbs free. Yep.
Here it is.
There you go.
Good work. Take this. The scribes are gonna love
reflex capacitor,
fun.
Not the flux capacitor.
I'll
whoops.
Want more tech, so believe me, when you're ready for more.
Yep, affirmative. Give me the
That's
next
what
mission.
I like to hear. I mark a location on your map. Our vertebrates
should give us the air. Cool. Guess. Oh man. That was slightly disappointing, honestly. I expected to be able to do a lot more, but lo and behold, we're not gonna be able to do much. That's quite alright, I guess. Honestly, it's just a big disappointment. So that's another mission that we will never be able to finish, honestly. Where are we going? Monsignor Plaza. That's not that far. Ticonderoga. I'm gonna go build a robotic workbench. Screw it. Let's get a better robot. No offense to Ada or anything, but let's just get a better robot. Also, I think it's faster to actually fast travel. Yeah, it would have taken me a long time. Really? That's 10 Pines Bluff that I'm able to build a robot workbench? I mean, I guess maybe they expected you to not be able to, you know, to have room to be able to do all of this stuff. So 10 Pines Bluff is one of those areas that you don't really mess with. So they kind of expected you to be able to actually have room there. Alrighty. And let's build this robot. Okay. I guess we can just build it anywhere then. Special. Here we go. Where can I put it? I'm gonna put it right here, actually. So, oh, wait a minute. Rad roaches. So, Kellogg's pistol. One. Nope. One. That's two. One. Two. And three. Also, I got a lot of meat from those guys. Okay, there we go. Can I actually build it? There you go, man. Robotic thingy is built. All right. How do I craft something? Select a bot. Ada. In order to modify a bot, either build a new one, press square to do so, or use your existing robot companion. So let's go with Sultron head. Medium engagement distance, Sultron. I want an Sultron. Damn, but I need to... Oh, damn. I need a lot of stuff to be able to do this. Okay, so head factory hardened armor. That's the best armor that I can see right now. Torso. No miscellaneous torso mod. Oh, wait. Assault on torso. Robo brain. Better health. Improved health. Superior movement speed. So health goes up. Carry weight goes down. No, I'd rather have her be able to carry more stuff. Front armor. Improves damage and energy resistance. Same thing. Increases carrying capacity. Okay. Guess we'll go with that. Rear armor. Okay. Hacking module. Adds hacking subroutine. Adds lockpicking subroutine. I don't really need any of that stuff. So let's go with the left arm. Why are you standing there, guy? Superior melee damage. Reduced carrying capacity. Superior melee damage. Superior carrying capacity. Improved melee damage and carrying. Okay, so this is the best one. The robot brain. Oh, it lowers her damage resistance, though. Okay, let's go. Let's still put the robot brain thing. Left arm armor. Really, I can't put any armor on it? Assaultron. Ooh. Left hand laser. Left hand flamer. Fires jets of flame, reduced range, increased melee damage. Increased melee damage. Okay, let's see. Left hand vice grip. I'm gonna put a flamer on her. For the right arm. Sentry. Okay, that's the best one, I guess. Okay. Right hand laser is the best thing that I can make. Oh, wait, nope, I saw that. Right hand cryojet. Fires cryogenic spray. Reduced range. Improves the rate of fire. I guess that's pretty much all we can really do, man. Legs. Protectron legs. Mr. Handy Thruster or Protectron legs. Exceptional movement speed and improved carrying capacity. I'm gonna go with the movement speed. Thruster armor. Thruster factory armor. Okay. Let's go with paint. Aqua paint. Oh, it's literally just the paint. That's pretty cool. Pink. Red paint. I like that. Let's go with white. Okay. And I think we're pretty much done here, man. Yeah.
It's always fascinating watching you create.
Okay, that just sounded weird. Honestly, she reminds me of GLaDOS. I wish we could rename her GLaDOS. She reminds me of GLaDOS. Like, mostly just the head. It reminds me of the GLaDOS, the portal head.
Hey.
How may I be of service? Are you ready to install the radar beacon?
Yep, let's do this.
Let's do this.
Good. The installation should be simple. Once I'm in the robot workbench, just install the radar beacon and I'll do the rest.
Sure. Just install the radar beacon. Alright, there you go. Speak to Ada.
Heads up.
What can I do for you? A moment. The modification was successful. New hardware has been detected and software is updating. and installation complete. Analyzing nice. Mechanist hardware. The radar beacon is receiving a strong encrypted signal, but I can't determine the source.
That's a good start, honestly.
That's a good start, at least.
Absolutely. With some additional assistance, I should be able to decrypt the signal and locate the mechanist. Fortunately, awesome. I'm detecting another robo-brain in the Commonwealth that's receiving the same signal.
Finally, okay. We have an advantage.
Perhaps, but it isn't quite that simple. The encryption on the source signal is complex, but not beyond solving. If you can bring me two additional beacons, they should provide the keys and algorithms that I need to enhance my decryption routines.
Sure. And I'm not going to say anything. Okay, there you go. Let's make a joke.
Looks like it's RoboBrain season.
At least until our mission is complete. I'm uploading the location of the RoboBrain to your Pip-Boy now. Just be careful. These robots tend to travel in groups, so you're likely to encounter heavy resistance.
Fair enough. Awesome. Dude, that's a lot of experience. I love that. And the lag is real. The lag is so real. I guess we'll just start with this mission anyways. Okay, for some reason it was lagging when that popped up. Whatever. Collect the second radar beacon. Cool. So we need to actually find our way down here to be able to go all the way around. And then we're going to be able to collect our second radar beacon from the RoboBrain. How far is the RoboBrain anyways? That's pretty far. Dude, that's on a new island entirely. Okay, I don't think I'm going to be doing that just yet then. I think we will be doing something else entirely. For now. Nordhagen? No. Last Voyage, you can't do that. Talk to the guard captain. Silver Shroud? No. Talk to the settlers at Greentop Nursery. That's probably going to be the one I'm going to do now. Greentop Nursery is right over there. Nope. Apparently I haven't discovered that area. We can fast travel to the sinkhole, though, which is right next to that area, so we'll be good, I think. The Critical Banker perk allows you to save up an increasing number of critical hits to be used when they're needed most. Oh, I love that perk, dude. You can literally save up, like, I think it's 3 critical hits at the same time, so you can literally just essentially snipe someone from across the entire wasteland with like a 1% chance of hitting them, activate the critical hit, use it 3 times in a row, and pretty much get rid of almost all enemies, which is awesome. That's one of those things that I just love about this game. It has a lot of customization, a lot of, you know, customizable aspects to it. It's not just like, oh, you can customize your character. No. It's more so like you can customize almost everything about this game. You can customize the looks of your character. You can customize the stats of your character. You can customize how you shoot, how you fight, the weapons you use, all this other cool stuff. And I don't know why I went up here. Wait a minute. Was that a lockbox or lockbox? Was that a lockpicking ability that was that a lock? It was either a safe that I can get into, or else it was just... Nope, yep, it was a safe. Cool. I actually saw that right. That was awkward. There you go. Good job, man.
Got it.
Awesome. Awesome. We got some shotgun shells. He'd probably think that it's pretty cool, but... that people were abusing it to, like, steal and stuff. I honestly don't know. That's just what I'm guessing. Okay, there you go. Greentop Nursery. We're going to be fighting a bunch of raiders. With the cool new robot that we have, we're going to be able to see her in action. I'm also going to cook some stuff before I go. Grilled rad roaches. Mutt chops. Okay. And we are done here. Yeah, they send me. Yes.
Yes, I'm here to help. What's going on?
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies. Threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Don't worry, I got this.
I'll take care of those raiders for you.
I hope so. We didn't know what to do.
Awesome. Now we actually started this mission. Wait a minute. Oh, it actually is all the way up. Right, Dunwich Boars. I forgot about that area. Huh. Well, this will be some good experience, honestly. And hopefully it'll all work out for us. Otherwise, it's just going to be very awkward. You know, having to die again and again and again. Because I remember the last time that we went there, we were like level 20 or something, and all the enemies were like level 30. They, like two or three of them didn't have skulls next to their names. The rest of them had skulls all over their names, and what the... What is that? An Assaultron. Okay. That's pretty much part of the DLC. We're gonna be fighting against, like, Assaultrons and stuff. Actually, I don't even think that's part of the DLC. I think that's just a random Assaultron that's out in the wild. Dude, she is powerful. Love this new upgraded version of Ada. Take all this stuff as well, though. Mr. Gutsy model. Why you do this? Wait. Okay, no, I thought that was another Mr. Gutsy model, but that's just Ada. She seems to be doing pretty well, man. Okay, so that was a smart move on my part, giving her maneuverability and giving her close-range weapons, essentially. Other than the laser, because obviously the laser is, like, long-range. Mid to long-range, I would say, is the best use of it. But it's still pretty cool to actually see her in action and see that she is a freaking beast. She's not someone that you want to really mess with. She's someone that you take seriously. Nope, didn't mean to do that. Okay. Let's go with that. Okay, what the hell? I was trying to... There you go. There you go, and... Can't do anything. That's alright. Ada here is gonna just wreck them entirely. Man, I love her new upgrades. Big fan of it. Big fan of it. Bloatfly meat. Is there any more bloatfly meats around here? That sounds weird. Okay, I don't see any more bloatfly meat, though. Okay. Guess not. Anyways, I think I'm actually going to end the episode here, so thank you guys very much for watching. As always, take care, and goodbye, sus, as we discover the slog. What's up?
Corn's really growing in, huh?
Alright, see you guys. Wow.